Sean Zatel, theboxingvoice.com here with undefeated featherweight, one of the best in the division, Joseph Diaz Jr. Jojo, this time though, you're facing a fellow undefeated fighter. What are you thinking heading into Saturday night?
I'm thinking, man, it's going to be an all-out war. We got two undefeated young prospects going and putting the undefeated record on the line. I mean, there's a lot at stake for both of us fighters. Somebody's O has to go, and whoever wins this fight is going to be the next big thing for Golden Boy at 126 pounds. So I'm going to go out there and just perform. I had a 10-week training camp, good preparation, and I'm ready to go out there and just please the fight fans and give them an exciting fight.
Well, I'm interested that you say it's going to be a war. Do you really feel that way? Because you're a great, very good technical boxer. You don't really have to get into a war. So why do you say that?
I say it's going to be a little war because Manuel Villa, he likes to move around to create angles, and he is a taller fighter. So I feel like I'm going to be fighting on my front foot a little more and be the aggressor and making sure that I'm dictating the pace and throwing a lot of combinations. So if I'm dictating the pace like that and if I'm putting a lot of pressure, he's going to be throwing a lot of shots as well. So I think that it is going to be a war. Once I have that pressure, then I am going to be able to fill him out and outbox him and stuff and create my angles and keep my composure. But overall, it's just going to be a good fight.
Well, again, that's interesting you say that because, like you admit, you usually outbox these guys side to side. But you're saying you're going to have to go after this guy. Kind of show something you haven't had to show yet, but how good do you think you're going to be in that style?
I think I'm going to be good in that style because overall I've been sparring taller fighters this whole training camp. I've been sparring taller fighters that like to move around and create angles, and I was able to cut off the ring and be the aggressor in there and make sure that I was landing my effective shots. So overall, no matter what, if Manuel Villa likes to move around, I'm gonna be ready for him. If he wants to bang, then I'm gonna be ready for him as well. I feel like I covered all bases this whole training camp, and I'm ready for whatever he brings to the table.
Now you've been punching better and better each fight, hurting your guys more and more. Do you feel like the power is coming more into play, and that do you want the stoppage Saturday night?
I feel like the power is coming to play, and I feel like I am turning down on my shots a little more. My body is just developing a lot more, and I'm growing into the 126 pounder that I feel like I am today. Come Saturday night, if the opportunity comes where I have him hurt, I am going to go for the kill and I'm going to stop him. But if not, it's still going to be an exciting fight. I'm going to go out there and give the fight fans my 110% and just try to come out victorious and give the fight fans an exciting fight.
We hear about the top of the division, Gary Russell and, of course, Oscar Valdez and even Leo Santa Cruz. Do you feel like people are overlooking you a little bit, or it's just that you're still in a little bit in the prospect stages? What do you feel about how you're stacking up to them and what people think?
Yeah, you know what? I think after this fight, I am going to be one of the top big names at 126 pounds. I felt like I made a name for myself throughout my previous fights, but with Manuel Villa, he's an undefeated young prospect, just like me. So if a victory over him come Saturday night, I feel like I am going to be on in those big names. And right now I'm ranked number one in the WBO. I'm ranked number two in the WBO, so hopefully if...
WBC, one in WBO, two in WBC.
Two in the WBC, but if everything goes well and I come out victorious, hopefully one of those sanctioning bodies, those organizations, puts me in mandatory, and I'll be willing to fight the champion.
Well, it's good that you're number one for WBO because the champion is Oscar Valdez, and that's who your name comes up with the most, the fans. That's the matchup they want to see. That's what they speak on. They want to see Valdez and Diaz. Is that the fight you want in particular?
I mean, I want anybody. Anybody that has a bout at 126 pounds. If it's Oscar Valdez, if it's Lee Salby, if it's Leo Santa Cruz, if it's Abner Mattes, whoever has a bout, I'm coming after them because I want a title around my waist. So if the opportunity presents itself where it is me and Oscar Valdez, I'll be willing to take that fight. And I know Oscar Valdez will be willing to take that fight too, because it's going to be one exciting fight for the fight fans. Hopefully we could have it in LA and have a sellout in LA.
Absolutely.
And just go out there and perform for the fight fans. But right now I'm not overlooking my opponent Manuel Villa. I still have a tough competitor ahead of me come Saturday night, so I'm focused on him right now.
I did want to ask about Gary Russell. Kind of seems like a guy nobody would really want to fight in the division. Do you agree with that? Or
no? You know what? I don't think I think people want to fight Gary Russell. It's just that he takes a lot of time off during his fights. After his fights, he takes a break and stuff like that. So it's hard to get a fight with Gary Russell. But I mean, I'd be willing to fight Gary Russell as well if the opportunity presents itself. I want to fight nothing but the best fighters. I want to showcase to all the fans that I'm not afraid of anybody and I'm not intimidated by anybody. I want to go out there and showcase that I'm willing to fight the best and I'm going to beat the best.
Joseph, just thank you for your time, man. I always look forward to seeing you fight on these big pay-per-view cards. And if you win, I would love to see you against Valdez.
Thank you, man. Thank you for your time as well. And thank you guys for all your support. Tune in Saturday. I'll be on the pay-per-view portion of the Canelo Chavez live in Las Vegas at the T-Mobile Arena.
Don't miss it.
Don't miss it.
Thank you, champ.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
Appreciate you.
Thank you, man.